name is Hiroyuki Tajima. So, in this movie, I like to explain the normalization condition of the wave function in the Gross-Pitaevskii equation. So, in the previous movie, I explained the structure of the Gross-Pitaevskii equation. So, that is the equation for the minibody wave function of the condensate. So here, I like to explain the normalization condition of this wave function. So in general, this wave function depends on the position of the each particle, R1 to Rn. Now, we consider the particle, particle number is now n, large n. Then, in the case of the Bose-Einstein condensate, we assume that all particles occupy the lowest same single particle state. So I mean here I express the single particle state by using the phi r. So r is now still a position of the particle. Then from the knowledge of the basic wave function, we make a normalization condition for the wave function. So here so of course, since this many-body wave function is now depends on the various position of the each particle R1, R2, R2, Rn, then so this is the wave amplitude of the wave function. So I mean the absolute value of the wave function is now can be integrated by the position. Then this one should be unity because of the normalization condition. Here we can use this assumption. So this wave function is now product of the single particle state. Then this normalization condition becomes like this. So just simply substitute this one to the here. Then we can see the so this phi r is now so this equation is now some product of the integration of the Ri of the phi Ri here and the absolute value and the power 2. So then, so this normalization condition can be reduced to the this simple equation. So this means the single particle state wave function is now normalized by like this. So this is important information for deriving the Gross-Pitaevskii equation, which I previously introduced. So then, that's all. So next, I'd like to explain the more detail of the Gross-Pitaevskii equation. So then, thank you very much.